Harman's utility function is x1, x2, his income is 100, price of good 2 is 4. Okay, utility function is x, y, ले लेता हूँ मैं इसको. Income is equals to 100, price of good 2 is 4, so py equals to 4. Good 1 is priced as follows. The first 15 units cost 4 unit, any additional units cost 2 per unit. So px is equals to 4 for x less than equals to 15 and 2 for if x is greater than 15. So 15, okay. What is the what consumption bundle does Harman choose? Okay, so first of all, I want to find the budget line of this person. So in such situations, I'll first plot the budget line. So price of income is 100 and price of good Y is 4. So the maximum amount of good Y that he can consume is going to be 25. Right? 25. Okay. Now, price of good X is 4 for the first 15 units. Okay, price of good X is 4 for the first 15 units. So the till first 15 units, every unit of X cost 4 rupees. Okay, and price of good Y is also 4. So every unit of X, so till X is less than equals to 15, Px upon Py will be equal to 4 by 4, which is equal to 1. Okay, so the slope of the indifference curve for the first 15 units is going to be 1. So it will look like this. This is 10 and this is 15. Because when prices are same, buying 15 units of X will cause you to lose 10 units of Y. Okay, and now after 15 units, now for X greater than 15, you have px equals to 2, py will still be 4. So px upon py will be equal to 2 by 4, which will be equal to half. So the slope of the indifference curve after this will become flatter. Okay. Now px by py is 4. So when you lose 10 units of y, you can buy 20 additional units of good x. Okay, because good X is now half costing you half of what good Y is costing. So at this point, if you can afford 10 units of good Y, you're spending 40 rupees on good Y. Now if you give up those 40 rupees, if you instead spend those 40 rupees on good X, you can buy 20 additional units of good X. So the maximum amount of good X that you can purchase is going to be 35. 15 plus 20 is 35. Okay, so now I have the entire budget line. Now I want to find the indifference curve which gives you the maximum utility. Okay, so what consumption bundle does Harman choose? Okay, now the thing is, agar yehi char options hote mere paas, if in exam you had just these four options, you could have simply substituted these options in the budget so in the utility function and checked ki utility kis pe zyada aa rahi hai. But right now you also have a fifth option E, which is none of the above. So you do not know if the maxima is amongst these four options or not. Maxima could be something other than these four. If the options were only these four, then I would just substitute all these values and check ki utility kis pe zyada ja rahi hai, because unke alawa koi answer hoga nahi. But since this none of the above is here, I cannot really be sure ki answer in charon mein se kuch ek hai. So that's why I need to find what the actual optima is. Okay. So let's do that. So IC kis type ka ho sakta hai? So IC would be the maximum utility. IC would be a curve like this, jo yahan pe tangent ho. Okay. Or it would be a curve like this, jo yahan pe tangent ho. Okay. So you have to find the tangency condition for both this part and this part. Okay, so it should be one of these two situations jo tangency mujhe degi. Okay, so व्हाट आई विल डू इज आई विल जस्ट एक बार मैं MRS जो होगा हियर सपोज द ऑप्टिमाइज अ पॉइंट लाइक ए देन द MRS हियर विल बी इक्वल टू 2 ओके एंड इफ द ऑप्टिमाइज अ पॉइंट लाइक बी हियर देन द MRS हियर विल बी इक्वल टू हाफ. सो एक बार मैं MRS 2 लेके अज्यूम करके ऑप्टिमा सॉल्व कर लूँगा और एक बार मैं MRS 1/2 लेके ऑप्टिमा सॉल्व कर लूँगा एंड देन आई जस्ट कंपेयर द पॉइंट्स ए एंड बी. सो लेट्स टेक केस वन विच इज़ MRS इक्वल टू 2. ओके सो व्हेन आई टेक MRS इक्वल्स टू 2 माई इक्वेशन सॉरी MRS इक्वल्स टू 1 सॉरी MRS इक्वल्स टू 1 है यहाँ पे प्राइस रेशियो इज 1 सो MRS इज 1. सो व्हेन आई टेक MRS इक्वल टू 1 माय इक्वेशन बिकम्स MRS ऑफ दिस यूटिलिटी फंक्शन इज y बाय x इक्वल्स टू 1 व्हिच इंप्लाइज y इक्वल्स टू x. ओके y इक्वल्स टू x एंड देन बजट इक्वेशन इज px x प्लस py y इज इक्वल्स टू i. एंड रिमेंबर दैट द फर्स्ट केस करेस्पॉन्ड्स टू दिस सिचुएशन. इन दिस सिचुएशन यू हैव एक्स लेस देन इक्वल्स टू 15. फॉर एक्स लेस देन इक्वल्स टू 15 यू हैव पी एक्स इक्वल्स टू 4. सो आई एम गोइंग टू टेक पी एक्स एंड पी वाई बोथ 4. सो 4 टाइम्स ऑफ एक्स प्लस वाई इज इक्वल्स टू 15 सॉरी 100 एंड वेन आई सब्स्टिट्यूट एक्स इक्वल्स टू वाई हियर you get 8 times of x is equals to 100 which implies x equals to 12.5. okay so x equals to 12.5 which implies y equals to 12.5. okay so the point a is basically 12.5 point comma 12.5. okay and it will lie on the yellow region of the your yellow arm of the budget line because this x coordinate is less than 15. okay so remember the condition for the yellow region is x less than equals to 15. so you need to make sure that the value of x that you obtain in your optima on point a should be less than equals to 15. similarly when you solve for point b I should obtain that the value of x coordinate in b should be greater than 15. so let's solve for point b. So utility at point sorry MRS this second case is MRS equals to 1 by 2 which is equals to y by x which implies x equals to 2y and then I'll use my budget constraint. So px here you have px equals to 2 and py equals to 4. So that's the condition I'm going to use because when x is greater than 15 you have px equals to 2. Okay so px is equals to 2 and py equals to 4. Okay so the budget constraint becomes 2 times x plus 4 times of y is equals to 100. Okay so this implies that x is equals to 2y. So 2 into 2y plus 4y is equals to 100 which implies 8y is equals to 100 which implies y is equals to 12.5 which implies x equals to 25. Okay so x becomes equal to 25. All right. सॉरी आई यूज़ द रॉन्ग बजट कंस्ट्रेंट सॉरी 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 मैंने बजट कंस्ट्रेंट रॉन्ग यूज़ किया है. ऑलराइट सो द क्वेश्चन इट स्टेट्स दैट एडिशनल यूनिट्स कॉस्ट 2 पर यूनिट. सो सपोज यू आर कंज्यूमिंग सो सपोज योर कंजम्पशन ऑफ एक्स इज सपोज योर एक्स इज ग्रेटर देन 15 ओके, दिस इम्प्लाइज दैट द फर्स्ट 15 यूनिट्स दे कॉस्टेड यू 4 रुपीज. सो सो यू स्पेंट रुपीज 60 ऑन द फर्स्ट 15 यूनिट्स दैट यू बॉट. ओके, सो 60 रुपीज तुमने स्पेंड कर दिया ऑलरेडी. ऑलराइट, सो आई एम ओनली इंटरेस्टेड इन द एडिशनल एक्स क्वांटिटी दैट यू परचेज. सो द एडिशनल एक्स क्वांटिटी दैट यू परचेज दैट इज एक्स माइनस 15, दिस शुड कॉस्ट यू 2 रुपीज ईच. सो द अमाउंट स्पेंड ऑन द एडिशनल एक्स क्वांटिटी इज एक्स माइनस 15 इंटू 2. सो दिस इज द एक्सपेंडिचर ऑन एडिशनल एक्स. ओके, प्लस वाई का प्राइस तो सेम है. सो 4 टाइम्स ऑफ वाई, दिस शुड बी इक्वल टू, सो 60 रुपीज हैज ऑलरेडी बीन स्पेंट ऑन द फर्स्ट 15 यूनिट्स. सो द अमाउंट ऑफ मनी डैट यू हैव लेफ्ट इज गोइंग टू बी 40. ओके, सो एवरीबडी गेट्स दैट? ठीक है, सो एक्स माइनस 15 इंटू 2 प्लस 4 वाई इज इक्वल टू 40. दिस इज योर बजट कंस्ट्रेंट. Okay, your budget constraint looks like this because x does not have a fixed price. Okay, I cannot do x into 2 because the first 15 units cost you 4 rupees. The next, everything after 15 units is costing you 2 rupees. Okay, so this is your budget constraint, and then I am going to substitute this x equals to 2y here because x equals to 2y will still hold. X equals to 2y is coming from the MRS condition. It has nothing to do with the budget line. It is just the MRS condition. So, if prices are in the ratio 1 is to 2, the MRS should be equal to 1 by 2. Okay, so MRS price ratio should be equal to 1 by 2, and MRS of this equation is y by x. So, I can substitute x equals to 2y now. So, when I substitute x equals to 2y here, I will get 2y minus 15 into 2 plus 4y is equals to 40. Which implies 2 into 2 is 4, 8y minus 30 is equals to 40, which implies y is equals to 70 by 8. So 70 by 8 would be what? 8.5, right? Y should be equal to 8.5. In any case, x will be equal to 2y. X will be equal to 2y, so that's 70 by 4, so this should be equal to 35 by 2. Okay, this is not 8.5, this should be 8.75. Okay, and this is 35 by 2, which is 17.5. Okay, so x is equals to 17.5, and remember the condition for here was x greater than 15. So I'm getting x equals to 17.5, so the condition is satisfied. Okay, so the point B becomes, this point becomes 17.5 comma 8.75. okay, so on the right arm of the budget line, the maximum utility happens at this point. On the left arm of the budget line, maximum utility happens at this point. So one of these two points will give you the absolute higher utility. I want to just check which point it's going to be. So you can find utility at point A and utility at point B. So point A is 12.5 comma 12.5. So you can find utility at A. Point B is going to be 17.5 comma 8.75. So you can find utility at point B. Okay, we have been given 12.5. 12.5 is the answer. So let me just open my calculator and check it quickly. 12.5 into 12.5, that's 156.25. So utility at A is 156.25 and utility at B is 17.5 into 8.75. So that's 153.125. So clearly point A is giving me higher utility, so this should be the optima.